destroyed my lawn.
You know, I'm really getting sick of this. I just shaved yesterday, and now I've got to go back and do it again.
They wrecked my car.
We gotta do something about this. You and me, we're gonna thin out their numbers some, right? Alright.
We did what we felt had to be done.
Alright. Let's go to the...
Dearest Kyle. Mark Twain once said, "How hard is it that we have to die?" A strange complaint to come from the mouths of people who had to live.
Original bottle.
Oh, shit.
I wrote you a poem. Kyle. Kind. Yellow-haired. Liked animals. Excellent at drawing. Your brother won't return any of my calls. I feel so lost.
Mr. Bradley!
Who wants to know?
I knew I'd find you here. The name's Richard Klein.
I went by your house. The yard's a complete mess. Mr. Bradley, I have something here that you need to see immediately.
I don't need anything from you or anybody else. If you're after Kyle's money, it's gone. Spend the last of it on this steak and this mallet.
Mr. Bradley, I can assure you I'm not after Kyle's money. I'm here because you're the only man that can help.
What exactly are you getting at?
Mr. Bradley, what I'm referring to concerns Waldos.
What the hell did you just say?
Waldos! I've seen them!
Lies! That's impossible! Kyle and I wiped them out exactly 1 year ago today!
How can you be so certain the Waldo threat is no more?
Because I was there! The Waldos have been eradicated!
Listen, Bradley! I came out here for one reason. To see the man that knew the secret to finding and killing Waldos. But all I came upon was a drunken mess. A shell of a man. I know Kyle's death was hard on you. Hell, life's hard. You've got to move on. How many more lives have to be ruined by the Waldos? But seeing you like this, I can tell you'd rather sit back and let it happen.
I was part of a team. Half that team's gone now. I haven't fired a gun since that day. You want me to go back out there? Back into the woods where I lost my best friend and a piece of my soul? Your mind's warped. And I don't need this right now. Goodbye.
You really think you're the only one who's been affected by the Waldos? I'm not just talking about having to reseed my lawn or run it into my truck. My best friend was eaten whole by a Waldo as well. And here I am ready to bring the fight back against those things. But I'm gonna need help. And the greatest Waldo hunter this world has ever known is turning his back on what he knows is right. What would Kyle think if he saw you like this?
Don't you ever say his name!
I'm sorry. But you owe it to yourself. Especially to the rest of the world. To at least take a look at my proof. You've been around them long enough. They must know your smell. Why not just finish it?
If I ever see you again, I'm calling the cops. I do not hunt Waldos anymore.
Will you at least take my card?
Going in the trash as soon as I get home.
Richard Klein.
Yeah, we need to talk.
Says here that Waldos, Capriolus vitulina, thrive on grass and very little water intake. Humans rarely see them as they tend to blend into their surroundings. Waldos are distinguishable by their red and white striped torsos, dark rims around the eyes, and a red and white head apparatus with a red sphere on top. The legs are blue, and only the top tier of Waldo society hold canes to show authority. No known case of Waldos has ever been produced in the wild. They're a strictly synthetically made creature, genetically engineered by a once well-respected neurosurgeon who in the early 1980s had his medical degree taken from him for undisclosed reasons. The doctor swore he would take revenge on the very people who stole the only thing that gave his life meaning. That's all it says.
That's the most ridiculous thing I've ever heard. Who wrote that book?
So let's say Dr. Albright.
The man has no idea what the Waldos are capable. That book must have been written right when they were discovering them.
Says here it was written in 1988.
At least we know the truth about those things.
But I thought you said you and Kyle wiped out the last of those creatures.
That's what I thought, but apparently not. I'm fairly certain Waldos can't reproduce.
Well, how do we know they can't breed?
Well, because all the Waldos I've seen in the wild have been male.
Oh.
They were engineered that way.
But, again... how do we know they're all male? Did you ever go up to one and look up its Waldo skirt?
This book right here says that all Waldo chromosomes are controlled. It's really not that difficult. All synthetic intervertebrate embryos are inherently male anyway. They just need an extra hormone at the developmental stage to make them female. Waldos are simply denied that.
John, the kind of control you're talking about, it's not possible. If there's one thing the history of evolution has taught us, it's that life will not be contained. Life breaks free, expands new territories, and crashes through, painfully, maybe even dangerously. But, well, there it is.
You're implying that a group consisting entirely of males will breed?
No. I'm simply saying that life finds a way.
So what do you suggest we do? You said at the graveyard you wanted to bring the fight back against the Waldos. I've only seen one in over a year. Maybe they've migrated away from Alexandria?
How are you with a 9mm?
Exactly why I need your help, John. I've never fired a gun before. I want to be up there right next to the greatest Waldo hunter of all time. I have to avenge her. I must. You're the only one that can help, John.
I think I know just what we need.
Try to be best, cause you're only a man, and a man's got to learn to take it. Try to believe, though the going gets rough, that you got a hand tough to make it. Try and you succeed. Never doubt that you're the one, and you can have your dream. You're the best around. Nothing's gonna ever keep you down. You're the best around. And nothing's gonna ever keep you down. You're the best around. Nothing's gonna ever keep you down.
lot of Waldo-based activities reported in and around this area in Virginia. Maybe that's their breeding ground.
Do you really think we'll be able to bring them down their own home turf?
First kill's always the hardest. After that,
should be fine. Just never go scouting on your own. Kyle learned that the hard way.
Left flank. What was I thinking?
I'm not gonna listen to you beat yourself up by your friend Kyle anymore. Make them pay for what they did to your friend. That's all we can do.
You're right. The spirit of Kyle is alive and well in this 12 gauge right here.
You should set that spirit free. Set that spirit of hot lead free. Right into the belly of a Waldo. That's what he would have wanted.
This is where the map says the concentration of Waldo activity has been reported.
My God. These things could be anywhere.
Only one way to find out. Let's go, Tom.
To stop a Waldo infestation if there is no Waldo infestation.
I just don't get it. This place should be crawling with Waldos. It's getting late. We should set up camp, hunker down for the night.
It's a warm night.
Sure is. I always love this time of year. You could hunt all day, then just drop your gear and make camp.
Emily would elect you. I think she'd have spent all her time outdoors if she could have. We're always going on hikes or picnics. Thing just ate her alive, John.
Sounds like a fine girl. We should get some sleep.
I've walked a white line my entire life. I'm not about to screw that up.
White line's in the middle of the road. That's the worst place to drive. Come on, let's go.
What's wrong?
They're here.
How can you tell?
Because that wasn't there last night. Grab your gun, nothing else. We've got to move.
Where are we headed?
Saw an old structure on the way in. We'll head there.
Then what?
I don't know. I'm making this up as I go.
See the truck from here. We can probably make it if we sprint.
I'm afraid not. Looks like we got a Waldo grazing right by our exit.
Big deal. We shoot it and run.
Not so fast. We unload a round and we're gonna have every Waldo within 2 miles headed straight for us. You wanna try and outrun a Waldo? You still have your knife.
Shot.
I learned from the best.
That's some fancy work back there. Been hunting Waldo long?
Afraid not. That was my second one. Man, it was rough out there.
Tell me about it. We dropped one, what, 15 seconds. We had them swarming all over us. We hadn't hightailed it out of there, we'd have been goners. Oh, I'm sorry. This is Phineas here, and my name's...
Jackson!
Well, if it isn't Big John Stead, you killed my brother. Douchebag.
Waldo's killed your brother. Huh. Richard, it's Jackson, Kyle's brother.
Say, John, hope you're right about it getting easier. These first two are a real hassle.
Yeah, I heard you guys had some problems out there.
I'll be damned if they're not getting twice as aggressive. I was telling them earlier, if we hadn't killed them all at that moment, we'd have been goners.
Hey, what? How about you and Phineas join up with us tomorrow? We'll see what we can do about them.
Sounds like a plan.
See you tomorrow, 7 a.m., Dam Creek Woods.
Wouldn't miss it.
Are you sure you want to go back out there?
If we don't do this now, it's only going to get worse. You yourself said there might be breeding. It has to be done.
What about those guys? You sure we can count on them?
I hope so. Phineas and Jackson should be here any minute. What kind of sandwiches you end up making?
I brought juice boxes.
I told you to make sandwiches.
No, you specifically said you were going to make 3 chunky chicken and 2 peanut butter and honey.
I told you to make 3 chunky chicken and 2 peanut butter and jelly.
No, you didn't.
What kind of juice boxes did you bring?
I brought grape.
You know I hate grape.
I'm late, I know.
I couldn't find my car, and I'm not sure whose this is. Phineas will be along directly. He had to deal with his grandmother.
I understand.
I notice you're without Kyle's handmade novelty camouflage hat.
It's in the car. I only wear it during battle. To honor it.
As do I. Oh.
Do you need to take that?
No, no. This is just a reminder, actually, to take these.
I had no idea you were sick. I'm so sorry.
I'm not. I'm an addict.
Of course. Later. After we're victorious.
Ah! Here's Phineas now.
Let's do this. Richard? Safety's on, boys. God damn it!
Son of a bitch.
What did I just say?
Are you retarded, Jackson?
That's right, boys. Come and get it.
I think they're falling back.
That'd be nice.
Settle up.
Yeah.
Damn corn. Why didn't it just stop?
Ah! That was great! It's a shame they all had to die like kittens.
That was only the beginning.
What'd you say to me?
Nothing. Let's keep moving.
Said they could be evolving.
All right, listen up. Just form a line of battle on me.
Richard,
on my right.
You guys stay on my left.
Fire. Hold. Keep holding. Sit! We're on him!
Taking cover behind the trees.
All right, so let's punch them out.
Professional.
They're pro in his field to break the first rule of Waldo hunting. Never break from the group.
Pro in his field to break the second rule of Waldo hunting.
What's the second rule?
No.
Alright, so where'd they get?
Got one thing to say. I left your car to my sister.
That's fine.
She's in Denver.
I thought you just had one thing to say.
Ah!
get some work done.
And how do you expect to do that? We're surrounded by those things.
Yeah? And I figure I'm getting myself unsurrounded.
There's too many of them to fight off. Might as well just get out of the woods while we
you
still can.
You think I'm quitting, Bradley?
That'll be the day.
No one can count on you. Which way are we headed?
Only way we're ever getting to the upper hand is by surprise. Let's get as close as we can, send them back to hell.
Do you wanna see me?
So what happens now?
Well, I got a cabin and 20 acres in Reedville, right on the water. Thinking about calling that home.
Sounds mighty nice. I'd love to visit.
I doubt we'll ever finish them all off, but I think we made a pretty good dent. Been in the woods too long. Put it the best fight I could. I only hope God forgive me for the blood I've shed.
If he doesn't, then that's not any kind of God I want to know.
I just got one thing left I gotta do.
I wanted to call it.